Welcome to the new journey to paradise. My name is Michael. I am the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today in part 12, we will talk about Mount Zion, the dwelling place of the Father, the dwelling place of Yahweh. But before we start, I will remind you to subscribe, to like, to share the videos, to click the bell icon. And if you are guided by the Holy Spirit, please support us with your financial donations so that we can bring forth new videos and can establish new societies of the Rose in the nations and lift up the needy, the nameless and faceless. All the information you will find in the description box below. Today in part 12, we talk about Mount Zion. We always say that we walk towards the paradise. We walk towards Mount Zion, the dwelling place. Mount Zion is the dwelling place of God the Father. We Rosarians are called to come out of the world and to walk in the great exodus towards Mount Zion, the holy mountain of the Lord. As the Israelites came out of Egypt and met God at Mount Horeb or Mount Sinai, we will come out of Babylon and meet the Father and His only begotten Son Jesus Christ at Mount Zion. At Mount Zion, we will lay our hearts at the feet of God. We will have access to His holy place, and there we will be raptured into paradise. This will be the rapture of the church, not the escape of the bride who will come first. This will be the second one, the rapture of the church at the sixth seal. Read the book of Revelation, and you will see that at the sixth seal, we have a rapture and we have the sealing of the 144,000. A great multitude, clothed in white, will stand before the throne of glory, praising and worshipping Him who is our Father. At that moment, we will be transformed into His glory, and the 144,000 will be sealed for their assignments during the time of trumpets. We will have around 5 to 6 years until spring of 2024, because the sixth seal will be spring of 2024 to spring of 2025. So the time is short. I call you all out to walk with me on the new path, on the new journey to paradise, to establish societies of the Rose in the nations, to gather the people, to call forth the ones who want to be raptured into paradise. But it's not just only to be called forth. You also have to do righteous deeds, the righteous deeds of the saints. What are the white linen, your white clothes that you get? You have to do these daily sacrifices, these daily acts of love within the societies of the Rose. The time of sitting and waiting is over. Now you will go forward into the nation to be an example of the love of the Father, to be an example of the love of Yahweh. Mount Zion is His holy place, the place of the Father, the throne of His glory, the dwelling place of God, the place where we will meet our Father, our promised land, paradise. Join us, become a Rosarian, and be part of the multitude clothed in white, standing in front of the throne. Get ready, prepare your doorpost. We are leaving the world and we are walking towards our promised land. I am here to call you out of this world and to bring you together in sacred assemblies. It will be put under the protection, under the wing of the Father, because we are going for calamities. And when we come together and support one another and lift up the needy and do the work of the Father and walk as Jesus did, act as Jesus did, talk as Jesus did, raise the dead, heal the sick. And when we do all this one, we are fulfilling our destiny and purpose here on earth. The great exodus is at hand. We are leaving now. Are you ready? The Lord is setting you free from the world, Babylon and slavery. Do not stay behind, but walk with us a narrow path towards Mount Zion, where we will be taken away into paradise. Mount Zion is your paradise. There you will meet your Creator and will join His only begotten Son Jesus Christ as co-heir in His glory. There you will become a true son or daughter of God. If you want to read about this and if you still have some doubts, open the Bible. Look at all the verses about Mount Zion. You will see that the Father and the Lamb will come down on Mount Zion in full glory. You will find it in Revelation 14. You will find it in other places too. Read about the verses of Mount Zion and you will see what I'm talking about. Learn more about the great Exodus at our links here. Walk with us the narrow path towards Mount Zion. Receive your freedom and meet God the Father at His dwelling place to be raptured into paradise. We have a list how you could start with Triple Grace. But before I go to that list, I want to ask you something. You are signing up for our newsletters at Triple Grace at our interactive website. But you forget to register as a member of Triple Grace. So you will not have access to all the knowledge and all the wisdom and all the teaching that we are giving there. So if you want to register as a member at Triple Grace, then just where here now my name is, Hello Michael. There, when I click on this one, there you see here, there's when you are not logged in, then there is a login. You just press this one, register, and you become a member. Do not only sign up for the newsletter, but also become a member so that you have full access to everything. That was lying at my heart because I see many people registering only for the newsletter, but are not members. So become a full-fledged member of Triple Grace and enjoy all the benefits. Now here we have a page. You will find all the information on our website. And even what we teach is everything is written there so that you can go back. You can read it. You can read it again. If you have questions, you can send me the question either through the forum or you can send me the question through the support link or you can send me your questions to triplegrace55@gmail.com. I will answer all your questions. I know there must be many questions that you have, but read all the information we have. Read all our studies. Go for the teaching. Watch the videos and get an understanding first and then make a list of your questions and send them to me. So, how to start with Triple Grace? Change your life from the world to the Lord. That's the main important thing. Come out of the world, come out of Babylon, come out of the old-fashioned churches where you slumber away your salvation. Now, after you are saved through faith, by grace, now you have to go into the action part. Your heart will yearn so that you do good things. Now go forward and do it. Come out of the world and walk as the Lord did when He was on earth. First steps on your new path to Mount Zion. First, establish a society of the rose in your neighborhood by coming together with as many as 50 believers who are walking in faith and are willing to support one another and to lift up the needy and poor. We have a whole teaching about that, a whole video about societies of the rose. So please go back and watch that video. You get a lot of information there. If you have no society of the rose in your neighborhood that you can join, you can establish one by yourself. Bring true believers together. Not more than 50. Every day you will meet. Every day you will do a daily sacrifice of love. Going forth to support, help, even financial help, other people who are needy. You're looking for the Lazarus at your gate. Be like a small lion or lioness. Be like Jesus as He was on earth. Walk as He did, talk as He did, act as He did. Second, meet with this community of love daily and select one righteous project. Support of poor, orphanages, elderly, homeless, sick, etc., which you all will then attend to. And do that day. This does not need to be always in the form of money, but can also be active help or assistance. This is what we call the daily sacrifice of love. And that is also the reason why the Rosarians and the member of Triple Grace and the people in the societies of the Rose are called the daily sacrificers. Not because they are slaughtering a lamb. No, because they do a daily sacrifice of love for the Father, for Yahweh. Third, have regular love meals with the members of your society of the Rose. And on that occasion, break bread with them. Take communion to remember our Lord Jesus Christ. It is very important to have these love meals so that you bond together in your societies of the Rose as a family. Be there for any member of your society and teach them to support one another no matter what crisis may hit you all or individual members, so that fear of the future will be replaced with love for one another. Is that not what Jesus has commanded us? Love your neighbor and brotherly love? That's exactly what we are doing in our societies of the Rose. Love one another. And then you go forth and show that love to the needy in the world. Fifth, soon a strong bond will be established through the daily sacrifice and the love meals. And you will see blessings coming in from God the Father. People that you help will show up in gratitude, and you can use the occasions to spread the gospel of the kingdom to them. Or you will receive requests of people who want to join you. Six, as soon as you reach more than 50 members, please select 2 elders who will then start a new society of the Rose, because we are all equal and all should participate in the daily sacrifice, which would be impossible with a huge crowd of more than 50 members. These 2 elders should be always a man and a woman. Always remember that. It's very important because we are all equal. Seventh, during our daily meetings and love meals, select members to speak about their walk with the Lord, about miracles experienced, problems encountered during the daily sacrifice, dreams and visions, and spread the gospel of the kingdom to newcomers. These are the 7 steps you will do to start with Triple Grace. Do not worry if you cannot establish a society of the Rose right away. Then just become a member and follow our videos, follow our announcements, see everything at Triple Grace, learn from the wisdom that is poured out at Triple Grace and the knowledge, and then one day you will be ready to establish your own society of the Rose. The aim is to build a spiritual community that is active for all to see, doing acts of loving kindness in the name of the Father daily, but also supporting one another by helping through difficult times in the manner you read of in the book of Acts in the Bible. The first Christian communities were like our societies of the Rose. Quasi house churches, where they come together for love meals, for communion, for lifting up the people, for spreading the gospel. Having all in common, sharing resources, shining the light into the darkness, and set an example of love for all to see. These societies of the Rose should act outside of the world, without greed, without egoism, without hatred, without power lust, and without self-righteousness. Nobody is elevated above the others. We are all equal, including myself. And instead, come together in love, unity, and support for all to see. Be an example. The people should see, who are these people? Then the other will say, these are the true children of the living God. And they say, why are they so happy and content? Because you have a perfect life under the wings of the Lord, under the wings of Yahweh. The result will be that your environment will change and your mind will shift from the worldly desires to heavenly gifts. Try it, and the Lord will help you with miracles and wonders on your new path. If you have further questions about how to start with Triple Grace, you can easily reach out to us at triplegrace55@gmail.com. All are welcome. Come as you are. Even if you're full of sin, you will be cleaned on the way. and your stained garments will be changed into white robes, and walk with us the narrow path to Mount Zion, in the great Exodus. Please, watch all our videos that we have put up. Learn about the great Exodus, about the Joel 2 army, about societies of the Rose, about Triple Grace, about Sons and Daughters of God. All the videos are already up. Please watch them all. I thank you that you were here with me for this teaching. Please listen to it again. And if you're guided to help our ministry with a financial donation, so that we can bring forth new videos and can establish new societies of the Rose, as an example for the Lord, that we can lift up the needy as a daily sacrifice for Yahweh, then you find all the information in the description box below. And I thank you again that you are here with me for this special day, because every video is for me a special day, not only because I'm not a native speaker of English, but also because I'm with you and I love you all dearly, and I'm happy when we are together. Thank you for watching. My name is Michael, and I will see you in part 13. Maranatha.